by this one you can't change. It's same meaning and nothing
so
has changed.
There is, can you see this extra letter?
Oh, la mastum. This is
la mastum. Yes. So that is extra A.
It doesn't matter.
I do halves as well.
You do the halves as well as the vosh. That's already makes two crowns.
You know better about Quran and everything. Yeah, I don't know. I'm
isn't
a layman.
That, I am Christian. I know better about the Quran than Muslims. What is this one?
Qutila.
Qutila.
This is the right one.
Okay, this is the right one. This Quran is the mistake.
She never talks about the Bible.
She's just full of hatred.
Yes, she's hatred. That's it.
When you go back to Turkey,
yes, she's hatred.
Get ready. Get ready because Erdogan is going to rock
your head. Is that a threat?
Muhammad, he never married.
Shishna, all is it in your mind is now that Muhammad did something
in Iraq.
Isn't that so strange? I didn't even bring the Muhammad into the conversation yet, but you are very sure I am talking about your prophet. So let me ask my question again. Would you have sex with a 6 years old? Listen to the question. Would you have sex, you yourself, with a 6 years old?
You're taking your source from Wahhabism. From proof of Wahhabism.
I've had a lot of time in your life. With a pair of trousers on and a pair of underpants and the smoke still comes out. You think that's going to stop the virus coming out?
That's not my question. I am not talking about, I haven't even brought up your prophet yet. My question was, you as an individual who is wearing glasses, who is eating things, would you have a sex with a 6 years old? I'm not talking about your prophet yet. I will be talking about your prophet.
Listen, yeah.
Okay,
listen.
Thank you.
Jesus. My argument is,
you are
taking the story created by a guy.
You are not listening. Why did you leave your ears at home? I did not verbalize my question.
That's why you
are you happy that your prophet had sex with a child? My question was to you. My question was to you. You, as a man who is standing at speaker's corner, wearing glasses, who left his ears at home, would you have a sex with a child? That was my question.
No. You wouldn't. Muhammad, he never had sex with 6 years old.
He never.
So now.
No, he had plenty of sex.
Now.
So you fabricated this story, my brother.
Six is part of our life.
You fabricated this story, collaborated with an enemy of Muslim they call the Wahhabism. You're taking the source from books of Wahhabism to blame Muslim and the Prophet of Islam. He's been engaged in marriage, my brother. I'm telling you as a Muslim, our Prophet never engaged in marriage with a child. Never. You fabricated the story.
If your Prophet
fabricated the story from source of Wahhabism being supported by American.
Exactly.
You understand? Supported by American to come over here to blame them. What evidence you have that the Prophet is...
Let me respond. Do you have a problem if man called Muhammad, who is identified as the Prophet
don't
of Islam,
Muhammad.
Had a sex with
Muhammad
a child? Would you have a problem?
I don't hate Muhammad. No way.
I'm telling you,
would you have a problem? If sake of the argument, if that is correct, would you have a problem?
Fighter, he was. You know, he was. Muhammad, what they say about Muhammad is all fabricated.
What are you saying? I'm telling you.
If the sake of the argument,
you,
if your prophet had a sex with a child,
would
you be angry to him?
So we don't believe this story.
You don't believe it? Okay.
What's your problem?
You made it up.
Okay, what's your problem?
Last time when I checked, I was not Sahih Bukhari. Let's
Bukhari
read.
Is, no.
Let's
no,
read.
No, 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 that is my evidence.
Aisha.
No, please.
Narrated. Aisha. That the Prophet married her when she was 6 years old. And he consummated his marriage when she was 9 years old. And then she remained with him for 9 years. Sir, you are laughing. Would you have sex with 9 years old child? Absolutely not. Why?
In Mecca, 238.
So your religion says you don't have sex with a child. What is your religion?
Islam.
Your religion is Islam. Have you heard someone called Aisha? I'll talk to you. I'll talk to you. Wait, wait. I'll talk to you.
More bigger, more.
So what? Today we've got people who play basketball and rugby. They are bigger. This gentleman is bigger. So as a big man, would you have sex with a child? No, he is big. He wouldn't have sex with a child. Because Muhammad was big, that doesn't make all right for him to have sex with a child.
Islam is the married girls. Islam only they want to show a bad pictures of Islam. They don't want.
I'm so sorry.
It's not gonna work.
Please, accept my apologies.
No, don't leave.
Please accept my apologies. I am so sorry that I forgot to verbalize. Islam is the religion of peace.
Why don't you tell us about the Virgin Mary?
It is so peaceful religion. Tells a man can have sex with a child and divorce the child.
What about Virgin Mary?
It is so peaceful religion. Yeah. Orders killing of the people who criticize the ideology. It is so peaceful religion.
Yeah.
Man who made the claim it is so peaceful, run away. So peaceful. I am sorry, I forgot to verbalize that. Islam is the religion of pieces. Pieces. Pieces, brother. Come on, brother. If you haven't learned that yet, just read the book called Quran. My question. Sir, it doesn't work right now. It doesn't work right now. So there are Muslims.
You are convert Christian. You come from Turkey. It's not problem. It's not problem to choose another.
What it has to do where I am from? Does it change depend which country I am from, so I can critique Islam or I cannot critique Islam?
The Muslim.
Sorry.
Is the Christian as well?
I'm not Christian. I am what? Zionist. What is Zionist means? What does that mean?
I am defending
Satan. I am Satan. I am not Muhammad. I am not Muhammad.
Can you do me a favor? Can you position yourself just there? Because you're gathering quite a lot of people, which is good, but we're trying to keep it as COVID compliant as we can. So if we can go there, it gives us a bit more space this way, and we can keep
people
it
can move there, so you don't want people to
turn
move
around
there?
And that way. But I'm just asking for your help, because we're trying to keep it COVID compliant.
Sure, sir.
That will help us.
Sure, sir. Sir, can you explain it to me? Why did you, when you look at me, you saw your prophet Muhammad? Please explain it to me. Oh, because I'm full of hatred, therefore you looked at me and you saw Muhammad. That is the greatest logic ever. So you think your prophet was full of hate?
I am a Muslim and I am Christian. Okay?
Is that how you defend Islam? So the way you defend Islam, what you do is you critique and attack my faith. That doesn't work at speakers' corner. First, defend your beautiful religion. Can you defend your beautiful religion? I am Zionist. According to who? Sir, I am moving over there. Please come over there and explain it to me. I am moving this way. Come and explain it to me.
Thank you very much. That really helped.
Sir, why did you come to the... Sir?
No, you said that we are cousins. Like Jews, Christians and Muslims are cousins. That you said.
We are what?
Cousins.
We
follow the religion.
I am your cousin.
We follow the religion of Abraham. Are you not Christian?
I'm Christian.
We follow the religion. We follow Abraham alayhi salam. Christianity, Judaism, and Islam.
So you called me Zionist. What's your name? Sorry, what's your name?
Abid.
Abid.
Yeah.
So you called me Zionist, and now you are trying to explain it to me. Muslims, Muslims, Christians and Jews,
yes.
They all follow the religion of Abraham.
Yeah,
okay. Okay. So let me go to the basics. Let me go to basics.
Do you know Zachariah?
Who is Zachariah?
Yeah, Zachariah, the one that wears the Arabian
sir,
clothing.
Sir, I will talk to him. I will talk about him once we finish this topic. I wanted to give me your references.
Yeah.
How you follow man called Abraham? So Abraham.
He's the seed of Islam.
Abraham spoke to.
Seed of Judaism.
Abraham spoke to God. Abraham spoke the word of God.
She's not Christian. This lady's not Christian. She's a Zionist. Zionism has infiltrated Christianity, and you are full of hatred. You do not respect any other religion.
What I said was full of hate.
No, this lady.
What was it I said? Is the full of hate.
This lady is Lucifer. She is a worshiper of Lucifer, not Jesus.
All I am asking the question is from your own prophet, from your own Islamic sources. I am so sorry that you are so upset about your prophet.
Okay.
I am so sorry that your prophet thought it was all right to have a sex with a child.
Have you seen a Muslim try to burn a Bible? You ask any Christian here, they will say it's unacceptable.
I read, man called Uthman ordered burning of the Quran.
She burned the Quran right in front of everyone.
When did I burn the Quran, sir? When did I burn the Quran? When did I burn the Quran?
You are Lucifer.
When did I burn the Quran? When did I burn the Quran? When did I burn the Quran? Explain it to me. When did I burn the Quran?
2 weeks ago.
Where is your evidence? Excuse me. He's sure I did.
No, Hatun, wait.
No, you don't need to explain, sir. I can explain myself.
Yeah, Hatun,
if I burn the Quran.
He's not going to listen to you because he disagrees with you.
Because there are holes.
Look, she brought the Quran with holes. And then the rumor spread that she was burning a Quran. And she got more.
No, she was attempting. That's why she was surrounded.
Why should I lie? If they stated the same thing, I wouldn't have any problem with that.
So,
are you Muslim? Are you Muslim? No. Depend on.
Why is there a hole in the Quran?
Of course.
Let me explain it. Why there are holes in the Quran? Let me explain why there are holes in the Quran. So that's very important.
She put holes in it. Yes.
Sir, would you like to listen?
I wanted to ask her something. She never answered.
The mob lied.
She runs away from the questions you ask.
No, there's no video.
And plays her own game. This is how she brainwashes the people. This is how she brainwashes the people.
Quran is like an academic text. How did you come to the conclusion? Just a moment. How did you come to the conclusion that Quran is an academic text?
Why isn't it? Can you prove that it isn't?
It is not academic. If this is academic text,
you don't even know what it says in the Bible.
I am afraid your Muslim scholars wouldn't say there are different Qurans, okay? He is the Quran number one.
This brother is a good Christian. You are not a Christian. You don't represent Christianity.
Hatun, could you illuminate us for a second?
You represent it's Lucifer. Look.
Bring the video. Bring the video.
Are you scared to talk about it?
So,
yes, she put holes, but she never burned
one. So, Let me explain.
I would never do that to the Bible.
You would never do that to Bible, but you are calling me as the worst of creatures. You are calling killing of me. You are calling me, calling your wife to be raped. And you want me to have respect to the book?
Would you see a Muslim burning a Bible? We would
actually,
never do that.
I have seen Muslims burn to the Christians, not to the book. But they burn the human being.
Where is that? Where
I
is
have
that?
Seen
where
Muslims
that?
Even burn their Muslim brothers.
You are
ISIS burned the Jordanian pilot. But Muslims would have a problem if I burn the Quran.
What?
Did,
are you stupid?
Sir,
you are stupid?
What are you going to say to the Uthman who burned the Quran?
Ottoman Empire
Uthman, was Uthman, Caliph Uthman. Do you even not know who is Caliph Uthman?
Uthman, radiallahu anhu.
Did Uthman order the burning of the Quran?
And where do you get these references from?
No, Sahih Bukhari.
You're lying.
Sahih.
You're not, see?
ignorant.
She didn't even know how to. She didn't even know nothing about the Bible. Hadoon! You liar.
I am lying. Let's read it. This is just so much heartbreaking. Muslims are denying their own caliph the ordered burning of their book. Let me read it to you.
Her religion is Lucifer.
Listen very carefully as I'm going to read it to you.
She doesn't know about the Bible. She doesn't talk about the Bible. She never talks about the Bible.
She's full of hatred.
Yes, she's hatred. That's
and when you go back to Turkey,
yes, she's hatred.
Get ready. Get ready because Erdogan is going
to
rock.
Is that a threat? Oh, did you hear that? If I go back to Turkey, Erdogan is going to slit my throat.
Yeah, no, you deserve
I wonder why. Why I deserve? Because Erdogan follows the Islam. What, this is what happens in Islam. They say goodbye to your...
You're full of hatred. You don't really deserve life.
Let's see.
Life is about love. Learn to love.
You talk about hatred. Can I ask you a question? What happens to young Pakistanis? What happens in Pakistan?
With what?
If they don't convert to Islam, they kill Christians, don't they?
What happens in Jamaica when you're homosexual?
Why are you Let me give you the reference.
She's working for the government in Turkey. She's a spy for the
police. So I work for the government in Turkey, therefore they are going to slit my throat once I return to Turkey. Sir, are you Muslim?
Yes, I am.
Can I ask you a question?
Oh, yeah.
Are you aware that Caliph Uthman...
No.
Are you aware that Caliph Uthman ordered burning of the Quran?
Hold on. Miss Khatun.
Yes, that's my name. What's your name, sir?
My name is Muhammad Ali.
Muhammad Ali. Nice to meet you, sir.
Nice to meet you. Okay, wait. You've been dealt with by Adnan and Hamza and everybody. All these questions, if you dare, you will ask them.
Oh, well, I've been asking the questions to them. They're running away.
No, you run away.
You said you are Muslim. All I am asking is, can you please tell me if you have a problem, Caliph Uthman, ordering the burning of the Quran.
Man, look, I am not hold on.
When she's scared, she changed it.
Let me one by look. Let me speak.
Yes.
Look, you know better about Quran and everything. Yeah, I don't know. I'm a layman.
I am Christian. I know better about the Quran than Muslims.
Okay, good. I'll take that
as a compliment.
Thank you very much. I want to ask you. I come here to learn about Bible from you. Happy? Now, could you explain in the book of Ezekiel, chapter 23, is there anybody Egyptians here? He says Egyptian dick size is like a donkey's dick size. Can you explain to me? Please?
Of course, I love to explain that to you. But for us to move forward,
I give you the time.
Sir, excuse me.
Samuel, yeah?
I think so.
No, Ezekiel 23.
How many years
Ezekiel 23.
Sir, don't
play that game. Your reference is correct. Ezekiel 23.
About 3-4 years.
4 years, maybe more. Still you don't know that quotation. Hold on.
And what's your point?
The point is you misquoted because you believe. So you don't know.
I don't make a statement. I ask.
Correct me if I'm wrong. Correct if I'm wrong.
Samuel.
Correct if I'm wrong. You believe you have the Holy Spirit in you. Yeah? As a Christian, you have the channel, I know, I watch you guys on YouTube, yeah? I watch you. So you have the Holy Spirit, you claim, when you propagate Christianity. Am I right or wrong?
Yeah, and his name and is you, Angel Gabriel, by the way.
You have it, yeah? But you don't know, is that Samuel or Ezekiel?
Every newborn Christian has it.
He has the Holy Spirit. I caught a quotation, the Egyptian dick size is like, look, my English, yeah? Like the donkey's dick size, and you don't know the quotation. Can you explain to me how that filthy language get into Christianity, Holy Bible?
Of course, I love to explain that.
Thank you.
But before I love to explain that, since I was the first who I asked you the question, and you intentionally ignored my question, let me bring up my question again. Are you condemning your caliph who ordered burning of the Quranic manuscripts in 652?
You see, I told you with the answer, if you didn't hear me, Brother Adnan and Hamza and all dealt with you. Hold on. All dealt with you. Still, I can answer that. All dealt with you. So I said, I don't know.
So you hold on. I am not asking. Do you know what is the quantum physics behind that? I am asking, are you happy that your caliph ordered burning of your Quran?
I know the answer.
Would you be happy with that? Yes or no? Can't you even express your feelings at speaker's corner?
I'm sorry, I say Hinda.
No, we can answer you.
Hold on, I can answer you.
You ignore now.
Hold on, brother. Let me speak. You asked that question, and I told you, you've been put in the washing machine and rinsed in this question by Brother Hamza to all that names I said. Yeah? Hijaz, Muhammad Hijaz, they done it with you. I come to learn Bible from you, I said. That's how I put the question. Now you tell me, how did God went and describe the Egyptians' dick size as a donkey? This dick size. I want to know that filthy pornographic language. Explain to me, because 2 Timothy 3:16 says, all scriptures inspired by God. So you shouldn't be ashamed of describing the Egyptian dick size. How did that get in?
I must express.
I am still very much disappointed. I am not asking what the other missionaries are saying. I am asking, as a man, as a Muslim man, are you okay that your caliph ordered burning of your Qurans? Are you happy about it?
Do you get the answer?
There is no answer to that. But what is the answer? What is the comeback? Let's talk about the Bible. I am very much disappointed that Muslims want to talk about Bible while Allah is fall in love with the Bible. While Muhammad is fall in love with the Bible. While Quran is fall in love with the Bible. I am not Muhammad, sir. I am not Muhammad. Muhammad is the Satan. I am not Muhammad. And I am so happy. You look at me and you see Muhammad. Isn't that amazing? There is something in me. Muslims look at me and they see their own prophet. Difference is, I never went to top of a child. I never buy and sell people because of their color. I never order killing people because of their religion. But Muhammad did that.
If you don't talk,
still they have. Right, they look right, at me and right. then they Osama say, burn it. Muhammad.
Yeah,
he burned it.
Okay, you have.
Are you okay with that?
No, I only look.
Are you okay with that?
Brother Adnan told you.
So, bro, what did he say? What did he say?
They all been explained to you.
Tell me what did he say?
You go back to your own channel.
Tell me what did he say? Tell me if your brother, so-called Adnan, is happy that your Quran has been burned.
When he asks, everybody dealt with you.
Sir, I am asking your emotions. Are you as Muhammad Ali?
All right.
Are you happy that your caliph burned your Quran?
All right, I'll give you the answer for that. You happy? I'll give you the answer. Okay? So you want to know why Uthman alayhi salam burned
the Quran? I'm not asking why. I am asking, are you happy about it?
Look. Are you happy or why it is happy?
There are two different questions.
Do you want to know?
I want to know if you are happy that your caliph ordered the burning of the Quran.
Were you a witness for burning?
That's not my question.
Yeah.
Are you happy that Caliph Uthman ordered burning of the Quran?
No. Let me answer the way I say, the way I want. Yeah. Okay. So if you don't interfere, look. I was watching. I have a favorite TV channel, comedy channel. I watch Mind Your Language. Yeah. So the teacher come and write. Can you explain to me F-A-T-E? The Greek guy come. That's one fake, two fake. This is what happened when the Quran was revealed to Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam, and the religion was spreading continent to continent. Yes, people started to recite the Quran in a different dialect, just like Mind Your Language. The Greek guy, the Ali Nadim, people, anybody watch Mind Your Language, you know, person like me, a foreigner, when we speak English, my English language is different to one someone born here. Alright? So instead of A-E-I-O-U, the vowels we have in English, if I don't know, I will put cat to C-U-T, cut. We have a thing, P-U-T, put, B-U-T, boot. I will say that you, not you, any Englishman will say it's not boot, it's butt. This is what happened when the Quran was reading, people were reading, because it was written without vowels during Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam. So person like her start put the vowel feet, you know, F-E-T. It's feet, it's not feet, it's feet. So the guy who does it, he say 1 feet, like that. Usman alayhi salam has to compile the Quran, make it correct way to read. Everybody will do. For example, you write a sentence, the cat was sleeping on the bed. The word bed is written without the vowel letter. BD, the white man will put, the English man will put the E correctly because that is his mother tongue. A foreigner like me, A-E-I-O-U, I will put anything comes on my mind. This is what happened, and she knows that. She knows she that.
Know,
she,
know that.
She, now I answer your question. You ask me and answer me now. How come Egyptian dick size is been explained or described in the book of Ezekiel?
So, now let's...
Are you happy or not happy?
That was my question. For the burning of their Quran, they are happy about it. Let's have a celebration party. But they are not happy. The fake news going around that Hatun burned the Quran. What is it? I believe, I strongly believe, I am much better than Caliph Uthman.
Yeah.
You know why I am much better than Caliph Uthman?
Why, Hatun?
I can do a better job with the control transmission. He failed to do so. I will never give my child to man who is already abusing children. Caliph Uthman did so. But Muslims don't have any problem with their Caliph. They do have a problem with me. So that is the first point. Second point is.
Ezekiel chapter 20.
Second point is. I listened you. I listened you. Why are you not listening? What I'm my response? Why are you not listening what when I listened you? Second point is. Did you hear the argument? Even it wasn't my question. Even though it wasn't my question, Muslim told me why Uthman ordered the burning of the Quran. It was because the different pronunciation between but versus but. If it is the pronunciation, why do you need to get rid of the written manuscripts? If it is. If it is the pronunciation, but we know it wasn't the pronunciation, because we know people in Azerbaijan were calling other groups as kafir, disbelievers. If it is the pronunciation, you simply teach people how to pronounce but. You don't take their materials and burn them. That is one of the worst arguments for decades Muslims are putting forth. JC, I cannot pronounce something. Would you take my book from me or would you teach me how to pronounce?
Be educated.
No, let's come here, JC. Be good. Be good helper. Okay? So I cannot pronounce this word. I know which word it is.
Which word? Hatun.
Okay?
Which surah? Hatun.
So, Surah 66 verse 12,
yes.
It says, who guarded her chastity. How do you pronounce this?
Chastity.
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 Yeah, yeah, yeah.
Okay, so I cannot
example.
Pronounce it.
This
okay? Would you simply tear it apart and then take it out because I couldn't pronounce it? Or would you simply teach me how to pronounce it?
Teach how to pronounce it, Hatun.
Okay.
That's the most logical thing to do, Hatun.
So you are much better than Uthman Ida.
Yeah.
Well done.
You got a sticker. You got a sticker.
No, you don't get a sticker for that. So did you get that? If individuals cannot pronounce something, you simply teach them how to pronounce. You do not take their materials and burn them. But what Uthman did, according to Muslims, couldn't pronounce it in the correct way, he took their material and he burned it. and he's quite happy about it. I find that very much disturbing.
I'm a Muslim.
Do you condemn that?
Okay.
The burning of the Quran. Do you condemn the burning of the Quran by Usman?
Be quiet, man.
But you can't ask a question, though. It's fair to ask a question.
Quiet, please.
Do you condemn the actions of Usman?
Quiet, please. I'm talking to
her. Not your TV.
Sir, if you're talking to me, I am on this way. Can you just summarize? Sir, if you are talking to me, can you turn to me and summarize my last argument towards you? Can you please summarize my argument?
Allah Ta'ala help me from your own mouth now. Test it. This is the problem. I'm a Sri Lankan and I want to learn the Quran. I will learn, the different way.
Look, he would learn different way. What Uthman did, Uthman ordered burning of the Quran. So you are much better than Uthman. Congratulations. Since you are much better than your caliph, I think you should be the next one. Now, since we identified, there are certain issues with the Quran. There are certain issues with the Quran.
But I won't do that.
No, let's deal.
I won't do that.
Sorry?
It's not good. Respect your religion, respect your
Quran. What is the problem with that, sir?
So?
I can't hear you.
Look.
I respect you, therefore I am telling you are following false religion.
She's asking, yeah?
That's a book, sir. It is nothing in my mind. JC, leave it. No, JC, leave it. No. What?
Listen.
Why there are holes in it? I am trying to talk about it. Good question.
Look.
So I have got different Arabic Qurans, okay? And your Muslim scholars.
Ezekiel chapter 23.
Who is the scholar?
About what? What did I just say? There are different Qurans. I'll show it to you. Do you read Arabic?
Yeah, but you said this.
Do you read Arabic? Okay. Can you tell me what is the name of this
Quran?
Can you read it to me?
We were.
And then read it?
That's my language, but it's the
That's all it says? What does it in here say?
Yeah, she always comes, Quran burn, Uthman.
You said you read Arabic, tell me. What is the name of this book?
Worsh and Nafa.
Okay, this is Worsh Quran, okay? What is the name of this one? What is the name of this one?
Okay.
I hear you. I'm gonna prove you wrong. What is the name of this one? Okay. So you believe they are all the same? Okay. Can you tell me what is the name of this one?
This is Tafsir. Tafsir Quran.
Read. How many readings in here? Read. How many riwayats in here?
How many riwayats? What's mean?
Ayahs. How many ayahs?
Ala Hamish, a Quran. What's wrong with it?
What's wrong with it? Okay, now let's do the wrongs.
May Allah burn you in hellfire, man.
One Quran,
May Lord Jesus Christ reveal himself to you and bring to your knees.
May Allah, inshallah, for what she's doing, disrespecting like that, yeah? So look, she asked me a question.
Go to any ayah in all Quran, it will be same Quran.
Any
Egyptians here?
Of meaning, sometimes depends of the time, of the place, of this one. Meaning changing by the time, you understand?
No. Say it again.
Go to ayah, this ayah, 42, Surah An-Nisa. Go on all the ayah, 42, it's the same.
It's the same, okay. What if it is different?
What's the difference?
If it is, you don't believe there is any chance that might be different.
Oh, there is nothing changed because not me, not us, we do it ourselves. But he say we
okay, wait.
This Quran does not answer the question. One of the other nobody can change.
So I need you to speak slower for me to understand. Yeah? Say it again for me.
When we ask you,
there is nothing changed in anywhere similar. Anywhere. What it means by the time, for example, we are 2010. Thousands of years ago, it was different things, but it shows you for the same time, any time this world is coming, it will work with it, you know?
So, this surah, okay, this page, in every Quran is exactly the same. That's what you are saying.
Yeah, the reading here, but tafsir is going to be different because
I'm not talking about the tafsir, I'm talking about the Arabic Quran. Yeah. It's exactly the same. Okay.
Ezekiel chapter 23, verse 20.
What does that page?
He says the Egyptians' beak is like the size of a donkey's beak. Can you explain to
me? 85, yes, dear.
Just a moment, sir. Just a moment.
Levine Amenu. Same.
Okay.
Egyptian's beak.
يا الذين آمنوا لا تقربوا الصلاة يا لا تقربوا الصلاة وأنتم سكارى same nothing has changed
okay.
If there is any book it's been made it by different people to make you know differently this is them fault but nobody can change it
so can you read this word for me
أو لامستم
say it again
أو لامستم
okay can you read
أو لامستم
Can you look at them again?
Same, أو لامستم, the same.
How can they be same? While can you see there is extra letter?
This is not extra
letter. What is that
this
letter?
Is Arabic. Do you know what it means Arabic? Arabic is like we call like see everything. By this one you can change the same meaning and nothing
so
has changed.
So there is can you see this extra letter?
أو لامستم. This is
لامستم. Yes. So there is extra A.
It doesn't matter. It's meaning.
Okay, there is extra A but doesn't matter. Okay. Nothing. Okay. There is extra A and doesn't matter. So do you think does it matter? You are practicing Muslim?
Alhamdulillah, but okay. I'm not very good in Arabic.
Okay, that's fine. So you practice Islam. Before you pray, okay, let's say you are gonna do the morning prayer, okay? Yes. Do you do wudu before you go to the prayer? Soon after you wake up from the bed?
When I go to bed, I stand up. This is something near. Yeah, I'm gonna go to do wudu, then I'm gonna pray.
So you do the wudu and then you go to the prayer.
Yes.
Let's say overnight you had a sex with your wife, and now you woke up in the morning. Before you go to the prayer, would you do ghusl, okay? Or would you do wudu to go to the prayer?
Listen, this is something as fiqh. When you have this, you have to do wudu, then have a shower. You know, because we raf al janaba. This is a different thing. What's that come with this one? This is two things
okay.
different. I
don't understand. Okay, of course there are two different things. It is different when you have shower. It is different when you try to get rid of the Satan from your ear. Urine from your ear, Satan from your nose, and then get to the prayer. They are two different things. But both of them is the step for you to go to the prayer. You cannot pray, you cannot do just wash your hands and your nose after you have a sex and then go to the prayer. You cannot do that. So. Yeah, you can't even touch the Quran when you had the wudu. Yeah. So in Surah 4 verse 43, which you said is just a letter, doesn't change anything, okay? Application in one of them is touching in a sexual sense, in other one touching in a handshake, okay? So when you touch someone in a sexual sense, do you need to do ghusl or wudu before prayer?
Ghusl, you know ghusl? Ghusl is mean just with when you have a sexual, what we say, or even by feeling, if you feeling you did something wrong, you know, if something come out of the man, you understand, or woman, this time is going to ghusl. You understand? When, for example, if I touch, sorry to say, it's not nice, but if I touch woman with a feeling and something come off me, you understand? Something like how I have sexual, this time ghusl, you have to do ghusl. You understand? But that, Muslim, not allowed to do with foreigner person. If touching by accidentally, you don't have to do wudu.
JC,
yes, sir.
Can you shake my hand?
Of course.
Okay? If this gentleman is a Muslim,
yes.
Okay, before the prayer, does he need to do the wudu or ghusl?
His feeling. If he is feeling, for example.
So that was friendly handshake, okay? There was no any sexual contact in that. Does he need to do ghusl or wudu?
I told you, it depends on his feeling.
Okay, he already explained to you. He already explained it to you. It was just a friendly handshake.
Yeah, like say hello,
you don't have anything. You know, you don't have anything.
So no wudu, no.
You can go to pray. But I told you, if you feeling, because a woman, I'm a man,
yes.
I have a feeling as any man in here, yeah?
Yes.
Same as anybody.
Cardinal feelings.
If I feel with her, with that one, it's better don't shake, it's better.
Yes.
It's right
to avoid the...
Yeah, but if you did with your feeling, you understand? With your feeling, this is khilaf between ulama for this one. This is not a fitwa of me. Sorry, I don't say that. But I can make it haram for me. I have to put a wudu when I shake your hand. Maybe inside me, something can hear. Sometimes, even if you tell somebody, but you know yourself, if you feel something is wrong, not ghasl, you have to do wudu. You know? Wudu is the difference because ghasl was something like in a bed, you understand?
In a bed?
In a bed.
Yeah, when you have sexual intimacy with your
in
wife.
In a bed, yeah. If you have that one in the bed, and if sometimes,
yes.
If you have very feeling man, something's come out, you know what I mean, you understand? This time, the pain, there's two
things. The gastric fluid, you mean?
Two
the gas
things of water, you know? I don't know what, how to say in English.
Yeah, the gastric fluid, that comes from the ribs.
There's one of them you have to wear a vessel. One of them is just to clean that place, yes. With the water.
Ah, okay.
You understand? Two kinds of water of man is coming, you know?
Ah, right.
Yeah, that's what happens.
So, thank you very much for that one-to-one sexual lesson. But my question was to you. So there is this letter in here which you ignored, okay?
No, I didn't ignore.
And it is not in, auto-ignored, and it is not in this one. So applications are different between them.
I am asking you,
since one of them implies sexual touch, and the other one implies just friendly touch, which one do you need to apply in your daily life?
Exactly, I don't understand what you mean. Sorry.
So those two words,
yes.
They are different written, meanings are the different, okay?
It's
one of them,
same.
It's not the same because they are written differently.
It's not Arabic. Arabic, I don't know how to say it. Arabic, Bahar. Bahar.
Lamastum and Lamastum, they are different. According to Arabs even, they are different. One of them is this one, other one is this one. Other one is different. Can you see this extra letter A here? So it does change the meaning. So that's the first point. Let me give you the second rebuttal.
No, there is everywhere else. There is one.
I'm not talking about. Sir. Sir, you are not listening. How can it be accent if there is extra A there? How can it be accent if it is changing your practical Muslim life? How can it be just an accent? So now, let me show. Wait, I'll come to you.
The way to read it. I learned the Quran, so I know.
That's great. That's great. Wait. I'm going to give
you
the second example. Sir, here's the second example.
After he has
what is this word?
Read that.
Kutila.
What?
Kutila.
What does it mean?
Kutila.
Kill.
Kill.
To be honest, my English is not that very good to explain everything. Kutila.
What does it mean?
It's being killed.
Someone has been killed.
It's here, like what's it? Wakayin Nabi Kutila.
So prophets are being killed.
Okay. There's many prophets killed, we don't know them.
Oh, poor prophets got killed.
Your professor, they cannot find any professor of any other way in the world. They couldn't find any single thing is a different. Quran is all same.
So there is med. You give 2 seconds and there is...
Sir, wait. So let me show you the other Quran. Actually, you can still claim that, but your brother already saw 2 different Qurans. Let me show you this one.
That is like English and tafsir.
What is this Arabic word?
وكأي من نبي قاتل.
Okay, this sound is different other versus yes. Other one.
Listen, there is something like kasra, fatha, dhamma.
Sir, you said they were the same.
Riwaya.
So are the meaning of the, you pronounce them differently. Yeah. You pronounce them differently.
This book. This is not
watch,
Quran.
Watch your hand. Watch your
Quran.
Is this not the Quran?
The right
is this
one
not
is not
Quran?
In the Quran.
Is this not
that
the Quran?
Is in English.
Is this not the Quran?
Is this a mistake here?
Is this not the Quran?
No, it's not a Quran.
Is this not
the
Quran? The
one too. You've got.
Excuse me. This is not the Quran. Is this Arabic? Not the Quran.
No. This is translated in English.
Is this Arabic? Not the Quran.
Focus.
Arabic is the Arabic.
Yeah,
Quran or not?
No, but there is.
Is the Arabic Quran or not?
No, this is the Quran, but it's translated.
Okay,
in
Arabic
English.
Is the Quran. I'm not asking you the English. I ask you. This gentleman read this
the right
Quran
word
for
is
me.
Kutila.
Qutila.
Not Qatala.
Just a moment. Just a moment.
The right, this is the Quran.
What is this one? What is this one?
Qutila.
Qutila.
Ayyu min nabiyyin qutila.
Qutila.
The right one.
Okay, this is the right one. This is the mistake.
No, no.
Okay, this Quran is the mistake. This Quran is the mistake. Okay, let's get rid of it.
Sometimes we find the mistake in the Quran because the way how they, you know.
It's not translated. This is in Arabic.
Because we know the Quran in here.
So this is a mistake.
I know the words. I read it. But you are a perfect one.
So this is a mistake. Okay.
People, you know, you know,
this Quran is a mistake.
No, no,
this Quran is a mistake according to Muslim. But this Quran is not mistake one.
No, this
Quran
Arabic
is not the mistake
Arabic.
One. Okay?
It's a holy Quran. No. This is English with Arabic.
Arabic is
so the
mistake.
One
so now let's look at the another one. Let's look at the another one. It has nothing to do if I am Italian or not, which I am not. Which I am not.
From the beginning to the end. Here.
Okay, let's. Can you help me? Can you help me?
And not everybody can explain tafsir, do tafsir. Not me or somebody else. Nothing is wrong on.
Can you help me to find? Sir, can you help me to find Surah verse 146? What is this number?
This is Arabic numbers. I don't know it exactly, the numbers.
So I want you to find. Can you point me the same verse in this book? This is like another full Arabic.
And the Quran. Just to let you to give you
No. I want you to. So you already identified this book, okay, as the false Quran, okay?
No, not false Quran.
I am showing you the Arabic. So you identify this one as the correct one. I want you to.
Can you?
I want you to.
Look, look.
So you're saying one mistake.
I want you to. Can you show me verse 146? Can you show me verse 146? Verse 146. I'll hold it. Verse 146. Which verse is this?
146.
Look. Both.
Which verse is this?
Both is correct word. Both is correct word. It doesn't change the meaning, but it's just a little mistake of the like a
first
one.
But
okay, got it.
In accent.
Different word.
No, different word. It's still in the same word. It's just the way how it's. Qatala qutila is the same.
Qatala and qutila is the same. Even the pronunciation is different. Okay, that's fine. Let me just put in practice.
Qatala qutila is the same word.
Listen,
and
listen,
both
brother.
Is correct.
Both,
both is correct. But yeah.
How can both be, what is the meaning
just
of that?
One another.
What do they mean?
And what is the meaning?
Honestly.
Is killed, if so, killed.
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 Yeah. Qatala qutila is same meaning. But the right one is qutila. How do you pronounce it? Is qutila.
Okay. It's not the pronunciation. Qutila yaqmin.
No, there is qatala. There is another.
So what does the first one mean?
So,
it's the same meaning. The same.
How can it be the same meaning if they are written differently, sir?
No, look.
Like in English and American English is different spellings.
Okay, so in Arabic, you've got the American Arabic, and then you've got English Arabic. Yeah, everyone believed on that. Who bought that? American Arabic and English Arabic. Yeah. This Quran is from American Arabic, and this Quran is from the English Arabic.
Explain it. He's the verb.
Okay.
America.
As you can see, they are written differently. Okay.
By the way.
You don't need to be Einstein to see that. This is your word.
Yeah.
Okay.
Yeah.
I love you.
Can you find this word in here?
America is not here to help us. You know. America is here to screw.
You can't even find the word Qatala.
And if she's talking Christianity,
Tawarsan.
So there is difference. Qatala qutila yaqtuluna taqtuluna qutilhum. There is difference.
Sir, don't play that game to me.
No.
Word is here. Word is here.
No, this is qalil and this is a little. Not qatala. This is qalil. And it means a little.
Sir.
And they little, qalila, is
little.
Sir. So qutila. Qutila is killed.
Qutila is killed.
Yeah.
Okay. And what is in this one? What is in this one?
That's it.
And it's qatala. It's the same. It's the same word. It's the same word.
So if it is the same word, why are you pronouncing them differently?
That's a fair question. Come on.
Just a moment.
Why is it pronounced differently? Why? Is it because
they are the same word? Yeah. Why are you pronouncing them to me differently?
Yeah, it's a fair question.
Look, because there is in North Africa we have
قراءة ورش عن نافع. I don't know how to explain it. And in the middle east, they have قراءة.
Even from Morocco to Egypt, we have
حفص. قراءة ورش عن نافع. قراءة حفص. قراءة
there is. You know? That's not my question. My question was to you. You read those two words. You pronounce them differently, okay?
English,
if they are, if you pronounce them differently, then why did you pronounce them differently? One of them is Verkil, other one is fight. Okay, so do you want to be dead or do you want to just be injured? I want to be injured.
I'm from London.
I don't want to be dead.
When I say football, I say football. If I was from up north, I might say football. Yeah, right? It's the same word,
but different pronunciation.
How do you write them? Do you write them the same?
No, the same. It's the same. Okay. The right Katala.
You want to stay alive. You don't want to be killed. Arabic is a beautiful language. It is so beautiful. It is so beautiful. Now, this Quran, which has been read by Muslims in England and approximately 85% of the world, is identified as the false Quran.
Can we talk?
No. It's not a different word.
Because why? Because the word says fought. Okay?
I wrote in the same word.
Yes, it is two different words. He already pronounced them differently.
Exactly.
He already
Fatha, Sukun, Kasra. This is no mutual
mean.
Yeah. But the word is the same word.
Were killed.
Other one is fought.
And the other one is.
Can I show him?
Do you want to be dead or do you want to be just injured? Which one, sir? Do you want to be dead or injured?
Injured.
He wants to be injured. So that's the reason. That is the reason why there are holes in this Quran. Because Muslims and Muslim scholars cannot explain to us why there are different Arabic Qurans. It's the same thing you get to hear even from scholars. They cannot explain to us, and they simply say there are holes in the narrative. It's not funny, actually. This book affects your eternity, and you think it's laughable. That's not helpful.
So heads to head accept. Can I say one thing? Because I like the word truth.
Is wrote similar.
I am not here to defend any faith.
Okay, you are similar. I am not because here both of you are men, but you are different.
Can I say? Yeah, we are different.
You are not the same. You are similar.
Yeah.
Being similar change the meaning.
Yeah.
It does.
In America,
sir,
in here we spell mom M-U-M. In America, they spell
sir,
it
O-M. Sir, I am not falling in that trap. In Arabic, they don't have the English Arabic. They don't have the American Arabic. They don't have the
How can I have Irish
Arabic
with fanatic
Christian? They don't have it. They don't, sir. So it has been written differently. Meanings are different according to who? According to your Muslim scholars. Do you want me to show?
There were seven different recitations of the Quran.
No, according to who?
According to who?
There are seven.
No.
Bukhari tells you, but according to who?
They are all fabricated.
Okay. Where did you get the idea? That's the recitation. Bring the hadith to me.
We come from listen.
Show me the hadith.
You're not going to criticize my mother.
You don't have a phone with you.
Because that's where I am.
So you've been coming to speaker's corner for a while. I'm sure you memorize since you become your father asked you to become a Muslim and you become a Muslim. I'll open them for you.
Because these guys, they were racist, colonialists. They could treat us so badly before, and we're not here to
make... It's not your Quran. I bought it. I paid it, sir.
Okay? That's what I'm trying to say.
The moment I pay it, it's in my possession. I can do whatever I want to do.
Thank you. And imperialism.
Are you aware of the hadith which talks about seven different recitations?
Okay.
Look what are you aware of the hadith which is talking about the seven different recitations?
When they discover, how could you
your
discover?
Muslim brother is making a claim in
culture,
here.
The Anka and the Aztec and so many people living there for thousands and thousands of years, and you come and say
instead of going to my going to, can you go to
your hand? And now they are all Spanish. They speak the Spanish language. They don't know the same with my people. I am not an Arab.
recitation?
I am not an Arab, of course not. Okay. But the Arabs, they bring their religion, and they brought their language, and they make us defend. Now this guy is a Moroccan, he's defending the far away from Saudi Arabia, you know, and he's having that discussion, defending his faith, which is, that's
okay,
why
sir,
he, and trying
can you open for me?
To be the winner.
Where are you from?
That tell you
Morocco.
What we are,
okay,
as human beings.
Can you open for me? Sahih Bukhari.
We're all the same.
Sahih Bukhari. 661, 548, and then point out to me the word,
yeah,
which says recitation.
Because the
relationship in that hadith
is very personal matter. It's very personal.
Sahih Bukhari, volume 6, volume 6,
volume
6, 661, 514.
What's your point?
It's not my point. You are helping this gentleman. This gentleman says Allah revealed it to 7 different ways. Okay, can you read that for me?
Volume 6.
Volume 6?
Yeah.
61. Hadith number 514.
That's where Islam comes from. All the sheikhs of Islam, they come from Khorasan, At-Tirmidhi, Ibn Kathir, Ibn Hisham, all of them from Khorasan, Iraq. And all of them, Islam come from Khorasan, Quran come from Sham, come from Jordan area. Nothing to do with Mecca, all fraud. Same with the Bible, all rubbish. Muhammad
Sahih Bukhari, 661, 514.
Because we have no proof, no evidence whatsoever about Muhammad. We have Muhammad called Mehmet, which is a Ethiopian, the Armenian, and Muhammad, he was Nazarian, Jewish, a Christian, not Christian.
Is the hadith?
And
it,
yes,
the hadith says
the hadith?
7 different recitations of Quran. There's more than 7, you know.
There are 14.
In which, what, you have hadith that says that?
No. He's talking about different things. So you are talking about Ahruf, okay? He's talking about the Quran. There are officialized minimum of 14 Quran, but in 900 there were 50 different Arabic Quran. So I want you to, okay, find the hadith for me, which you say there were 7 recitations.
For you, yes.
I helped you, giving you the reference, so it's not burden is to you to give me the evidence that Ahruf means the recitation.
And Moses was Muslim, I know.
Al-Bukhari 3047.
Just a moment.
Jibreel. One style in the beginning, but the messenger of Allah hits her upon him, asking Jibreel to taught him 7 styles. All of
no. That's not the hadith.
That is hadith.
Open the hadith for me. No, this is not the full hadith. Open the hadith for me. I wanted to bring up the word and then tell me that is, make a case to me that is actually meaning.
This is an Islamic scholar here. We have the reference.
Okay, so you went to the Islamic scholar. Open the hadith. Open the hadith, sir. Open the hadith.
I have sunk your argument. I'm sorry to do that to you. But your argument has been sunk.
And you think that's funny? Sir, how many Qurans?
Yes.
How many Qurans there are?
We have only one Quran, not
so
how many Qurans.
In
just the way how we...
You recite in Morocco, you recite the Walsh,
yeah,
Quran. Okay?
Walsh.
This this guy doesn't recite the Walsh.
We know.
He recites the Hafs. Okay. How can there be still one Quran?
I do Hafs as well.
You do the Hafs as well
Hafs
as the Walsh, that's already makes 2 Qurans.
Not 2 Qurans, this is one Quran.
How can that be one Quran?
One Quran.
Yeah, I
just
don't understand.
I'll explain
it to me.
I'll explain to you.
Yes.
And Hafs, please.
No, 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 this is England and Speaker's Corner.
In Welsh we say Alif Lam Mim. In Hafs they said Mu'minin. In Welsh we say Mu'minin. So it's similar.
You already gave me two names of two different Qurans and you are telling me it is still makes one. I teach maths, it doesn't make sense to me. How can... Why would you go?
I think he was shy, I think, Hatu.
Why would you be shy? One plus one plus makes one. How can you be shy? You can learn. Those are basic maths you learn in like nursery or somewhere.
That's true, Hatu. Maybe he knows so. Bro.
Argument fails. That's expand my case. There are different Arabic Qurans out there circulating. A Muslim gentleman from Morocco recites the Warsh Quran. This Muslim recites the Hafs Quran. That already makes two different Arabic Qurans. Therefore, it is not surprising that Muslims are telling me there are holes in the narrative, because even the Muslims who are reciting the Quran are not able to unpack for me. Maybe it's my deficient mind, I don't know why, but there are like seriously holes, and Muslims know it doesn't make sense. What they do is they choose to run away. Today you can run away from these holes. You can run away. It's Speaker's Corner. You can go wherever you want to. Yeah. On the Day of Judgment, there is only one you will be stopping in front of. He is identified as the Lamb of God. He is identified as the Word of God. He is identified as the Lion of Judah. He is the just judge who has holes in his hand and holes in his feet. You will be standing in front of him. There is no way you can run away. Once you stand in front of the one who has holes and who has holes in his hand and holes in his feet, there is no way you can simply say, oh, let me take my things back. Because by that time, it will be too late. While you still have a chance, come to the one who has holes in his hand and who has holes in his feet, and he opens his arms and he wants you. Come to Lord Jesus Christ.